What is going on, guys? My name is Faye. My name's Faye, and today we're gonna play the Turing Test. Big shout out to XSplit, and big shout out to Square Enix for letting me play through this a little bit early. Super excited. I've really been looking forward to this game. I was gonna pick it up on Xbox One, but I was given a free Steam key, and right now we're gonna play through the first three chapters. I'm gonna upload this video. After that, I'm gonna do a no commentary video, which is in the link below. If you're looking for just gameplay and not an annoying person talking, that is the video for you. If you're looking for commentary and my experience with the game, you're in the right place. Now, about 7-8 months ago, I streamed a game called Pneuma, Breath of Life. That was created by Bulkhead Interactive, company comprised of Deco Digital and Bevel Studios, nominated for an awesome award. Pneuma was great. Fantastic game. I love first-person puzzle games. This is definitely... this is a first-person puzzle game. And once again, just big thanks to XSplit. Big thanks to Square Enix. Thank you so much, you guys. Let's go. Ooh. It's a load screen. Dude, those chairs look super uncomfy.
Morning, Ava.
Hello.
Your wake-up has been sanctioned by the ISA.
Thank you, Tom.
We lost contact with the ground crew 450 hours ago.
So crazy.
We have tried to establish further communications, but we are not getting any responses.
Okay.
We need you to investigate.
Okay, doesn't it make sense to do visual checks first?
We have already looked at the data. The ISA has made the executive decision that you report to the surface post-haste. You are our emergency response.
Cool.
What exactly is the emergency?
The ground crew found an organism the ISA believed to be dangerous. We need to re-establish communication.
Oh, nice. just straight up, the game looks beautiful. Damn. Super excited to see what happens. Tom, you seem a little shady. At least we were sanctioned to wake up. Aren't you thankful that that isn't the case for you? That'd be pretty rough. Let's look at this. Pretty good graphics. Kind of reminds me of Mass Effect 3 as far as looking out into space a little bit. Looks more like a painting than anything, but that's good. The lighting. Lighting and shades are really good. Let's go. So, it sounds like the rest of the crew had some issues. So we were sanctioned, we're the emergency response. Which reminds me of a CERT training that I went through a long time ago. CERT. Alright, can we interact with this? Oh my goodness.
001, speak and spell 404.
Looks like there's no information there, but kinda cool that you can interact with that. Okay, got the tough book. You know, I'm really surprised you can't do much with this, and maybe you can, I don't know. As far as I can tell, all you can do is really pick it up and put it down. Pick them up and put them, it's just, you know, some tough guy stuff.
Pick up your EMT.
Pick up that
EMT.
It's on the
side.
Okay.
Okay. We are going to take a lander to Europa. Make your way to the docking station.
Let's go jump in a lander, huh? Look at this. The EMT. User manual. Nice. It's got like this retro 1980s tracker keeper. You guys remember tracker keepers? Dude, I had some pretty sweet skateboard tracker keepers. By the way, guys, I do skateboard a lot. Do a lot of skate videos. And I'm starting a series that I am very excited about, but I'm not going to spoil. Could you imagine what would be going through your head if you were going to go to sleep for 10 years at least? What the fu? Holy flip. Holy mother truck. Holy flippin' freak. Guys, I'm doing Utah swear words. I'm from Utah, and I gotta say, we say some weird swear words that aren't really swear words. People get super mad, and they'll say stuff like, freak flip! Okay, let's go. I'm gonna stop talking. I talk too much. I like what he does with his wrists. like to get to know him better, and by him I mean her. Hello, Ava.
Ava. Wally.
Good dexterity climbing down a ladder. No big deal. I've done this before. Yo, I've climbed ladders before.
What's
I've descended ladders.
I have performed the necessary checks. The Europa lander is ready to launch.
Oh, is it? Oh, daddy. Why'd I say oh, daddy? Look at this thing, though. That is pretty neat. Pretty freaking sweet, whatever it is. I call it... Eric! I call it Eric. I don't know why. To hell with you guys. Fuck you. All right. Fantastic. I will keep the F-bombs
bay
to a minimum.
Three.
Bay 3.
Let's go bay 3, boys and girls. Let's see what we got. Dude, that bass hit was so good. Right in my face. Get in the chair, mother trucker. Yeah. Oh man, it's kind of like The Martian
Retro?
Almost.
Go.
To an
Fido.
Extent.
Go.
A little bit.
Guidance?
Go.
Control?
Go.
Telcom.
Go.
Then we are go for launch, initiating.
Zephyr.
Engaging retrofire.
That's really cool.
I'm running the program. 80 degree delta pitch to 88 degrees absolute. Braking procedure. Trajectory looks good. 502 alarm. It looks like we're coming in too fast.
Coming in hot, Brandon!
We are slightly short of the landing site. We are going to have to burn late. Go.
Full retrograde.
I say we explore the lore a little bit. I say we look around. Check out
the
environment.
Door.
Yeah, it was a lot like
Welcome
the Martian.
To Europa.
The Martian. Did I say the Marine earlier? Man, I'm tired. Oh. Damn. One medium climb for a woman. I got nothing. I got nothing witty to say. I am thinking a little bit about sleeping for 10 years, though. I wonder what that's like, if that's ever going to become possible. What do you guys think in the comments? Let me know in the comments, because if it's just like, you know when you've partied too hard, or it's just been a really, really, really long, busy day, and you sleep super hard and oversleep a little bit, and you wake up feeling groggy, I wonder how groggy you feel after a 10-year cryostasis sleep.
How long will my suit survive these conditions?
At 100 degrees Kelvin, a couple of hours.
Oh, nice.
We should get inside.
It'd be fantastic if it only gave you a few hours to complete. And then you had to start all the way over. Okay, let's go.
The base has changed.
What do you mean?
The base was originally constructed as modules to withstand the seismic activity in and around Theta Magna. It appears the ground team have manipulated these modules. The base was built initially by machines. I served as the mind of these operations. I arrived first on Europa in 2240.
Oh, wow.
It costs a lot to send humans into space with the necessary life support.
Tom's been here a long time.
Especially such a vast distance from Earth. So, robotics built this place.
I wonder why the ground team has changed these rooms.
I have a hypothesis. These rooms are Turing tests.
Turing tests?
Turing tests are tests designed to tell humans and machines apart.
It's a cool explanation.
Typically, problems only solvable by a human. A combination of logical and lateral thinking.
So, you can't complete these tests, Tom?
No. That is why I am glad you are here to help. We need to work together. They really have completely repurposed these rooms. I am quite impressed.
So, what were they used for before?
Most of them were used for storage. They have converted them beyond recognition. Perhaps they ran out of things to do out here. The devil makes work for idle hands.
Yeah, he does.
Do you know the ground team's location?
The crew are deeper inside the base, it seems.
They must be trying to survive. Can you find their precise location?
I'm afraid not. I am working to regain control. Though I once had complete control of this base, a lot has changed in the past 500 hours.
So if this base is managed by you, why can't you find the crew?
The base's communication array is malfunctioning.
Oh wow, look at this.
Perhaps we can't solve this yet.
Holy cow. 25. We have to light up 25 to get through there. That is incredible. So, it's almost as if they went a little bit crazy on this Turing test. They're like, hey, we're kind of bored. There's only four of us. We don't get along. There's nobody to sleep with. I want my money back. Yeah, what a pain in the ass. That thing just bouncing around. Alright, let's kick that boy in there. There you go, buddy.
This
not too bad.
What does not add up?
If there was an accident, surely they'd come to find me, not try to lock me out.
Seriously.
My instance is still resolving conflicts. I expect they have their reasons.
Okay. Yeah, it's a little strange. That's what I mean. They're just like, we're bored. Let's make an experiment. Okay. Can we kick this one down? It's already down. So, let's throw this on the side here. Ba-da-bow! And then, there we go. This would be a really fun game to speedrun, I think. It'd just be similar to speedrunning Portal. Man, so many good first-person puzzlers, and I'm so stoked I'm playing this right now, early.
Sorry?
I have two instances of my mind, two separate versions. A slave mind running on the satellite, and a master running here on the surface. When the communication was cut between the surface base and the satellite, the two instances of my mind were separated. So, during all this time, all of my knowledge divided into two separate branches. I continue to learn on the satellite, and I continue to learn on the surface. I am trying to merge the knowledge to create a timeline of what's happened here. But there are incongruities between these memories. Conflicts.
Can I pull one of these out of the wall? I get it, okay. Shoot it over here. There you go, buddy. That's gonna be a game changer. Okay, I think we needed to do it a different way, but that's okay. Pretty sure. Huh. Thought I had already done this, that's why it's interesting to me. Oh god, it's right there, guys. Look at this. Yeah. So then, I really overthought that puzzle. Holy shit. That's one thing I love about puzzles, first-person puzzlers especially. Sometimes you think it's so easy a solution. Think about trying to speedrun this, just like this part alone. Man. It's beautiful.
This is the command center. You can check on the crew status from here.
Okay. think that's how we keep going. I say we look around a little bit and get to know what's going on and spend a little bit of time. Utilizing the Pneuma electric fusion reactor. Cool. Look at this. It's like a, it looks like a construction boombox. I used to build houses with my brother back in the day. good times. Good times. We were always blasting Screamo or hardcore. Screamo's not really a genre, but, you know, whatever. I'm not very smart. So we got Chris and Daniel. And there's nothing on Daniel. That's kind of neat. So we know a bunch about Chris. And it's interesting that they're talking about... I'm guessing throughout the game there's going to be a common occurrence and a common theme of humans being AI and AIs being human. And just the whole idea of cloning a human into a sentient being. I think I messed that up, but that's okay. Let's go! Sarah Brooks' parents are both scientists. In her teenage years, she was sent to an English public boarding school. Where's she from? Interesting. So, okay, joint British and Syrian. Nice. Brooke is one of the most eminent exobiologists of the 23rd century. For her formative work on the Mars Discovery Project, she was especially requested to be part of the Europa ground team. Though only 28 years old, Sarah has touched the surface of two planetoids and spent more time on alien soil than any other member of mankind, except the Mars team. So guys, another thing I've really enjoyed so far with this game is the soundtrack. I am liking the music. It makes me feel things in the pants. Oh! Okay, maybe it doesn't make me feel things in the pants, but it is pretty damn good. Pretty good music. Oh, here we go.
Tom, start recording.
I am always recording, Daniel.
The day is January the 6th. My watch says it's 2:30 on
Tom's
Earth.
Voice is different.
Here we are, members of the human race, standing on Jupiter's moon, Europa. I am Captain Daniel McLean. I'm joined here by the rest of my team. It is our intention
that
to
sounds
make
really robotic.
And investigate life on this planet. Man's curiosity and appetite for discovery will continue to change our world for the better.
That's so weird.
Inspiring. And might I add my congratulations to you all.
That's so weird. So Tom, the robot, sounded more human than McLean. If you notice, not only did his tone not really waver that much, but all his pauses between words and sentences were exactly the same.
Here it is. Beautiful, isn't it? What makes this one more remarkable than the other? The way it attaches itself to other organisms. Its behavior is very abnormal. It seems to form a symbiotic relationship, most likely. How do you mean? Do you want me to dumb it down? I know what it means. What does it do? It attaches itself to almost anything living, but
what
it's not
the present. Hell?
It's quite alien.
Dude, he's talking about fapping right there. Interesting.
Mikhail, you seem distant.
Do I?
Yes. What's wrong? What's wrong, Mikhail? Mikhail, what's wrong? Are you listening, Mikhail? Are you able to hear?
Wow. Tom's voice, man. They really cranked it up on that audio log.
The ISA. They don't know what to do with this. The magnitude of the discovery.
We should send samples back to Earth, but we need to get this to a better lab. Unfortunately, I'm in trouble making enough clones.
Interesting.
We're gonna run out of the necessary resources to continue studying organism 119.
Huh.
They're calling for a grounding of all Europa transport until they get your report.
Wow.
Seriously?
Yeah.
That's rather drastic.
So it sounds like they're dead in the water. Like, whatever happened, they sound dead in the water. Oh, it's a tough book. You're a tough cookie! Look at that, everything- oh wait, no, arrived. What is this one? Hub 16, Europa Control. One arrived. Oh, never mind, we have a whole bunch. We have a whole bunch. Fantastic. It's different information, strangely. Oh my goodness, I wish I could throw some of the items after picking them up. Walking right through that. Jupiter! Jupiter is the second largest physical body in our solar system. It has a large gravitational impact which stretches and squashes Europa. It's cool. So the planet is actually stretching. Wouldn't you think there's tons and tons of earthquakes if that were the case? So I don't know if that's the first chapter. I know how far we can stream today. Not stream, I know how far we can progress to upload.
What condition should I expect to find the ground crew in?
Daniel went missing days ago.
Damn, Daniel.
Chris is presumed dead.
Damn,
we are expecting
Chris.
To find Sarah, Mikhail, and Sochi in a stable condition.
Chris is dead?
He was involved in an accident.
Okay. So, there is that. Move this, step through. Maybe it's that easy. Yep, there we go. Sucks that it seems like all of them were involved in accidents.
Could we take a more direct way to the ground team?
Unfortunately, there is not a direct route. The base is bedded under ice to protect it from the radiation of space.
Similar to the Mars base?
Similar. Europa's base is slightly deeper into the surface.
Huh.
There is more radiation present from solar events on Mars.
Wow.
But Mars's surface is denser than that of Europa.
Alrighty. So, it just seems like there's... think about leaving my family forever to search for something like this. Eh, well, we won't jump. That's fine. I was trying to jump the handrail, trying to do like a switch hard flip over that. I'm the first person to switch hard flip in Europa. Interesting.
Okay, what are their chances of survival here? Oxygen, the food stores, waste management.
Everything seems to be in order. It was a small problem with the food stores, but the crew fixed that up.
Good
we successfully transitioned over to a sustainable small artificial ecosystem in Europa, growing fruit and vegetables.
Growing fruit and veggies, huh? Not bad.
The crew members could hypothetically survive here for their whole lifetimes.
Okay. Oh wait, ladder's over here, genius. That's just interesting to think about. It doesn't seem like they've really planned reproduction with one another. Almost sounds like they're just trying to learn how to clone. Kind of strange. Alright. There's Mr. Block right there. Hello, Mr. Block.
Hello. Do you want some candy? Do you need it, Mr. Block?
Okay. Looks like we need to trigger something. Oh my goodness. I think I know what it is, actually. Probably have to power this bad boy. There you go. That's what I'm talking about right there. Alright, let's move this. Bop it, twist it, pull it, taste it, lick it. Bop it. Twist it. Taste it. Lick it. Lick it. It used to be a family game, until they added lick it, suck it, bop it, twist it, taste it. I miss the family version. Oh man, some pretty good hops right there. Got quite the vertical going. Oh yeah, I'm playing with a gamepad. Playing with a gamepad. A gamepad? What the f*** is a gamepad?
My purpose as the overseer of this mission is to work for the ISA.
Okay.
I am the ISA's feet and hands.
Sure you are.
Yeah. The distance between Jupiter and Earth make it inappropriate for the ISA to directly interface with the mission directives. As my AI core is stationed on Europa, I can make decisions instantaneously about the running of the base.
Alrighty. Looks like there should be another item. But, okay, what about over here? Yay, nay? Nothing? Nothing's over there? Shenay, nay? It just got so dark. Thought the game crashed. Silly boy. I wonder if we can pull this one off the wall. Can't pull it off the wall, but we can certainly do that with it. Okay, alright. There we go. So that'll open this. We can cruise over here, pull that, and run into this room. Yeah, buddy. That's what I'm talking about. We want that so badly. Alright. Now. Probably better if I get the other one. So here's what I'm thinking, and maybe we don't need it, but I don't know. Maybe perhaps better safe than sorry. Nah, it doesn't actually matter, does it? Don't think it actually matters. Ha! Poof! Fucked up. You messed up, sir. Put that in there. And maybe this is the end of the puzzle, maybe it's not. Ah, okay, so it does get a little bit more fun. We actually need to bring two things all the way over. Which I think I have a simplified solution for, maybe? No, I think we're gonna need to leave that right where it is. Or are we? Dude, I have no clue. I have no clue. It seems like I need to be able to take this with me and not have anything in here. And in order to do that, I think all I need to do is this. Kick him over that way, right? Grab this bad boy. Shoot him up there. Wait for it. Wait for it. Ba-dum-bum-bum. Interesting. I figured this puzzle out before. That's what's funny. That's what's funny about it. It's funny that I'm trying this all over again and I can't. It is just not working out. I almost feel like if we just take this. Okay. You don't see my idea? I'll show you. Here's my idea. No, that doesn't make any sense. So we still need to bring this up with us. Still need to have a way to take that upstairs. Yeah, I'm probably gonna edit this part of the video. I'm not quite sure what's going on here, because if I put this bad boy right here, there's nothing in here. And also, oh fuck, it's so easy. Okay, that's super easy. You guys ready? Womp. swamp. And then the other one. There you have it. There it is. I'm excited to get more into the story right now. Just listen.
How does the ISA know you're going to make the right decisions here when they can't communicate with us?
Interestingly, I have a twin on Earth.
Oh, wow.
His name is Michael. The ISA uses my twin to check firmware updates before they upload them to myself. There is a simulation of this mission on Earth, running at all times to check my expert systems.
All times?
Naturally.
Yikes.
As any modern artificial intelligence running on a quantum computer, I do also have a large amount of evolutionary algorithms at my disposal. However, they were deemed as too unreliable for general use in the mission.
Why is that?
Biological systems produce biological results.
Ah.
Messy, unpredictable solutions. Not suitable for such a mission.
Okay. Says you, the big giant jerk. All right. Now, question is, how do we utilize this? Okay, I get it. You guys ready? Ready for the big reveal? Just kidding. Just kidding. We gotta put that in there first. That'll kick the door open. Dude, what a good soundtrack though. This song, man. That is incredible. So I gotta keep that in there. It's almost like I need three of them. I don't know if you guys agree or disagree with that, but it certainly feels that way. Feels like I need to get this guy out. Like, grab this. Take him over. Run across. Put him in there. Is there another shoot, though? It seems like there should be one more shot. Okay. Because we just need two of them, right? Not too bad. In other words, we need to be able to leave here with an extra. And I think in order to do that, we actually need to do this. Okay, yeah, that'll give us one more. Kick that open. Okay. So, I think I got it. Check it out. We need this. We gotta pull that one from here. There we go. Alright, now I can easily get up top and shoot this. There we go. See that? Perfecto. Well, then again, I don't think the puzzle is over yet. So let's go. Let's give it everything we got. Take that. And that is all she wrote. That was a really good one. That was a great puzzle. But once again, just thinking.
Did the ISA build you, Tom?
As the child of the ISA, I have been given authority aboard this station. I was designed by the ISA and the Ashiyama Corporation, designed in California, assembled in China.
Nice.
But here on Europa, I constructed myself.
What? Tom constructed himself.
Have you heard of the Turing Test? Ava. It's a test to see if a computer can successfully impersonate a human.
Nice.
In the original Turing test, a human judge has two conversations, one with a machine and one with another human.
Oh, this is what it is.
They then
this
judge which of these polite conversations is with a machine and which is with a human. The machine being tested is said to have passed the Turing test, if the judge cannot reliably tell which conversation is with a machine and which is with a human.
Do you think you'd pass the Turing test?
I am quite capable of polite conversation. Wouldn't you say?
Oh, damn, Daniel. Give me that. Give me some of that. Give me some of that sugar. All right, so we need two of them, and that's how we exit. So we have one here that we can easily get to. And somehow I need to be able to take that with me, and I just figured it out. It must go like this. Let us go. Let's go. Hopefully I can do this one first try. That'd be great without a whole lot of thought. That would be fantastic. I always do that. You actually have to like press up against it almost. You have to be really close. You have to be really, really close in order to get that. I like getting close. Alright.
The Turing test has been criticized. Researchers claim it does not correctly test a machine's ability to think, but rather its ability to deceive.
What do you mean?
Well, have you heard of the Chinese room thought experiment?
I've heard about this experiment.
Imagine
it's kinda
you
cool.
are in a room. In this room, you are passed Chinese sentences through a slot in the wall. Inside the room is an instruction book written in English. This instruction book tells you which Chinese words to pass back through the slot in the wall as a response. By doing so, you have a conversation in Chinese. In the Chinese room, because the responses you pass back through the door are the correct responses, the person on the other side of the door is convinced you are a native Chinese speaker.
Well, they're wrong.
Perhaps they are not wrong. Because with the instruction book, you are having a conversation.
But the person stuck in the Chinese room is not aware of the conversation's content.
This is the problem with the Turing test. A computer can pass the Turing test, having convinced a human they are having a polite conversation.
Yep.
While the computer has no idea that a conversation has taken
even
place.
Occurred.
What if both of the people passing Chinese words are reading from instruction books?
That's the $26,000 or $28,000 question. Here's the thing. Watch this. The way this is tinted, like it's green, it looks like this is glass, like plexiglass of some sort.
I may be a machine, but I personally do not believe I am stuck inside the Chinese room.
Right, you would say that. I could peer inside your databases at any time, Tom, or pause your operation.
Do not assume I could not do the same to you.
Oh, talking about murder right there. It's murder one, sir. Murder one. What? How am I supposed to do that? How am I supposed to build ramps now? My name's Rod, and I do awesome stunts, okay? Do awesome stunts. I want to pull that one out, but I can't. That's what she said, that's what he said, that's what they said. Okay. Fuck. Holy shit. Okay, here we go. We've made it this far. Now we just have to figure out how to get another block. And I think it's over here. And there it is. Bingo. Now I can pull that one when I'm up here. Because it doesn't matter anymore. At least I did not think it mattered anymore. But it seems as though it does still matter. Stay there, little boy. Okay. Oh, baby. So that is allowing this door to stay open, if I'm correct. Let's go all the way over here and see. We just need to be able to do that, which shouldn't be too difficult. But if we take either one of the orbs, taking either of the orbs kills the, kills it. That sucks. Ah, I see. Okay. Easy peasy. We have to go through and then turn. I think we can pull it from the window. Perhaps. Yeah, I didn't even think about that. It's a little bit easier than I thought it was going to be. A little bit easier.
This is the crew's quarters.
Oh, nice.
It looks abandoned.
There's Daniel. What is WC? What is this? I do not see the need for so many cameras. Tom's presence everywhere is slightly oppressive. I understand the need for transparency, but why is he in the toilets? So it almost seems like Tom is just driving all the people mad after time with too much politeness. Let's go with Chris first. Let's see what Chris is all about. That's what I'm about, son. Yeah. Just profiling him. Papers on the ground. Pencils all over the place. Drilling reports. I don't know how you would have a family and crews down here. No, that's his brother. What am I talking about? Those aren't his kids. Louisville Slugger, even though it's not. It's like all yellow. It's a KRW. Ladies and gentlemen, the impressive KRW. There we go, KRW. Is that a mineral? Do you know any geologists that just like get mad at you when you miscategorize stuff? Oh yeah, I'd need a lot of that. I would need a ton of that. You got a hockey puck. Okay then, it's pretty good. And you know, you can't actually tell what these are. Rilizol. Let me know in the comments if anybody knows what that is or what it's imitating. That would be pretty sweet to find that out. Whose is this one? Sarah? Dr. Sarah. Sarah Brooke. A little bit OCD, a little anal retentive. Knows what she wants, though, and goes for it. Very organized. She's sexy, too. She's so sexy. Bo Bexy. Religious. She studies books called Science! Four white people make... Never mind. Let's not bring up race. Come on. No race, please. What is this? I don't know if I want to read through all of this. Not right now. I'm gonna leave that for you guys when you play the game. And once again, guys, this comes out on August 30th. It's coming out on August 30th. And it is $20 USD, 20 euros. Yeah, I can't even like read that. Can you guys? I can't read that. There we go. That was weird. It didn't load. It's my hypothesis that the crew is controlled by this implant. This is their strong aversion to helping me. I need a method of suppressing its impact. Perhaps a drug. Okay, that's what it was for. Maybe an antidepressant, so minimize the condition effects. Where the fuck did he get an antidepressant? I've managed to get Chris on my side. He's agreed to test some medical procedures with me in private. Maybe they're just finding out that they're not actually human. Ooh, got some needles. That seems fun. Nope. Dang. And we went in here already, didn't we? No, we totally didn't. Oh, dude, that is such a terrible picture. It looks so photoshopped, man. It looks so bad. Get that wedding ring going. I do love these trees. I'm a big fan. I am too tired to remember what they're called. That just happens. Happens when I haven't slept for a long time. Bonsai, baby. Not exactly. There are many causes of death other than DNA damage. It would not save you from trauma from brain damage. from cardiac arrest. So basically just make you zombies. That sounds fun. The overachiever reader, huh? I will be reading that later. In my own time. In my... Ooh. Musician, though, huh? Completely blank. I'm gonna say, I need quite a few video games. And Twitch. And YouTube.
Loading. Loading.
That was pretty good. There were some good puzzles and some thought-provoking dialogue. I feel like chapters 1 through 3 really set the game up. And
these
that's
people should not have been sent here. It's
really
not
cool.
Manned space travel is not safe. Since mankind first entered space, the debate has raged over the value of manned space travel. There is a large contingent of the ISA that believes all tasks that need to be performed on Europa could be performed by machines. It is obviously less risky to send machines rather than humans.
That's cool.
We sent drones to Earth's moon. Scientists can remotely operate drones. If we did it there, why not here too?
Teleoperation became possible on the moon when the communication latency was reduced to 1.4 seconds. The distance between Earth and Earth's moon is approximately 1.3 light seconds. This enables near real-time control of drones by scientists.
Nice.
The story is different with Europa. As the distance between Earth and Jupiter oscillates between approximately 32 and 53 light minutes.
Okay, I get it.
It takes a very long time for Earth to communicate with Europa. Due to that distance, teleoperation will never be possible on Europa.
Huh. Okay, but why not control drones from a satellite?
Why not indeed? My systems can be teleoperated from
Europa's
satellite.
That's his answer. Why not indeed?
That is when the communication lines are open. However, the advantages of human fieldwork apparently outweigh the risks.
Huh. Outweighing those risks, mother trucker. Okay. So, we just need to make... We need to be able to grab something we can take all the way over here. And that's it. I've never actually looked at this box closely. That's creepy. It looks like a spider leg or something. Just spinning out of control, ready to eat.
I'm going to murder your family now.
Oh god. Sounds delightful. Okay, so once we're in here though, we're trapped. Oh, we're not. Okay. That is how we open this door. Right? We gotta open these two doors and still have one left. Can't shoot through there. Probably has to do something with moving this arm around. Like, the arm needs to come back to the right. And then I can grab it from there. You know what I'm saying? That will be the case. So perhaps I had it in the correct place in the beginning. Just overthought it. Yeah, that's exactly what happened. I thought a little bit too much about it. So, shoot that there. Grab this. That's gonna help us though. Because now I still don't have anything, you know? Okay, that's. Once again, I overthought it. Much easier than I planned on it being. Much, much easier.
So, why can't you solve these tests, Tom?
I am not permitted to think laterally. Parts of my systems are permitted to use evolutionary algorithms. This simulates what is called creativity. However, evolutionary algorithms can converge on inefficient and ethically suboptimal solutions. Since this is the case, I am only permitted to take actions in response to a set of constraints.
What do you mean by morally suboptimal?
Solutions to problems that transgress ethical boundaries.
Oh, good. As long as there's no ethics involved. Who needs ethics, you know? Who needs it? I'm just kidding. Okay, can I... Is this door gonna... Okay, there's not a door. We can take this all the way back down. Seems like we're gonna need... this. We're going to need to take that with us. And in order to do that, I gotta shoot this here. Pull that out. Put this here. I can't remember where I shot the other one. Did I just son of a bitch. I just kicked it off. Okay, I'm gonna need to take all of them with me. That's the interesting thing. So I gotta put this back. And by that, I mean drop it again. Which is perfect. That's what I wanted. That is exactly what I wanted. You know, what a great puzzle game. Anything that makes you a little frustrated and then gives you that response of just laughing a lot because you're annoyed. That's a success in my book, so I'm gonna be really careful. Drop that there. And now we can take this with us. I think this could be the game changer. Then again, I think if you've never had sex with your significant other and they're pregnant, that's also a game changer. Ha 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 ho ho ho. Okay, you're gonna go in there, mother trucker. You are gonna go in here. And before I pull that one, I'm actually gonna shoot this here. Now I think I can grab both of these, right? Yeah, check that out. There's the one, throw it in the bottom. And then we have Mr. Top. Mr. Top. Thank you, Mr. Top.
Why does a lack of creativity stop you solving these tests?
Well, I contend that problem solving is creativity.
Okay, there we go.
These human interaction tests are exercising your creative mind.
I don't see how problem solving is creative.
Think back to the beginning of these tests, to the first puzzle you solved. It required you to throw a box through a window. Do you remember?
Yeah, I think so.
I simply had never thought to throw a box through a window. That is creativity, thinking outside of the box.
Oh, okay. By throwing a box. Ha! Hilarious. So hilarious. Okay, what the front door? What the front door am I supposed to do right here? Oh, okay, that's easy. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Let's pull this back down. And then run around. Pretty easy. Pretty dang easy.
Can a computer ever be creative?
Yes.
They can. But a computer's method of creativity is to try everything until something works. Think of nature. People consider nature creative. The process of evolution by natural selection. It perhaps started with one organism. It essentially tried to create every organism it could. Those organisms that did not survive perished. So, nature's creative force is to try every conceivable idea.
Good old
those
nature.
Ideas that work, survive.
Okay, so why aren't you permitted to emulate that process?
Because the solutions that a biological process creates are not always good solutions.
Oh, okay.
As we see, nature is morally ambivalent. It will happily create morally suboptimal ideas to fulfill its creative mandate. We see this in parasitic worms, viruses, and pathogens.
Nice. Super deep game. I really should have slept a little more for this, but ultimately, I can't wait to play through this one more time and really digest the philosophy.
You weren't restricted? Do you think you could be creative?
As creative as a human? Certainly. You believe yourself to be a creative? But in mathematical terms, creativity is merely constrained chaos.
What do you mean?
I have discerned that creativity is divergent thinking.
Oh, Okay.
Creating an organic solution to a problem. In the human mind, divergent thoughts are created and then curated by the frontal lobe. I can create divergent thoughts and moderate them. So, I am creative.
Huh. Organic solutions?
Organic, in that it is developed through a biological process. Whether that is the process of evolution or a computed process.
Now I need to be able to shoot over there. Probably with a green one. Let's go find out. That was a really fun puzzle.
Okay, so you could solve these tests, but in a terrible fashion. Can you think of a solution to this one?
Chop off your arm and leave it on the button. That way the door will stay open.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, that's not a great solution.
No, it's
you
really
threw
not.
The box through the window. Perhaps we could throw you through the window.
Oh, wow.
Actually, Tom, I think I'm okay for help.
Right you are.
Now, if I pull this again, is it going to drop? Okay, that puts that there. And once that is there... Oh, okay, okay. Didn't realize I could... Ah! What a freaking bully, freaking ledge. What a dick. Not bad. I didn't even need to do that. I didn't even need that thing.
Can I have an update on a crew?
That's awesome.
I have not managed to track them down.
It will have been 6 years since I've seen them. Or anyone, actually.
They have locked all the doors. I would
They've
not
locked
expect
all
a
the
warm
doors?
Reception.
Well, at least they're expecting us.
So, it looks like I need to pull this one out. Right? Pull that out. This one first, that second. And I think this is what you're supposed to do. Just line this up to the right. Kind of a pain in the ass. These are really touchy. These controls. Alrighty. Now, at this point... I gotta think this through here. Gotta think it through. This... Okay, we got it. Yeah, buddy, first try, right there. These things, that just looks like a big capacitor. It's really, really interesting. Really cool.
So what was the need to send us here?
When the ISA discovered life on Europa, they deemed a ground crew necessary. The advantage of human field workers is that they can adapt to new knowledge more effectively. I, apparently, was not cutting the mustard.
Did he say cutting the mustard?
A computer may be able to interact with new knowledge, but it does not know the value of that knowledge.
I don't know, though. What do you guys think? Do you think a computer knows value of knowledge? I mean, what does it really mean to know the value of knowledge? Aren't we just programmed based off of experience, just like AI? What makes us that much more special? I think it's Rick Astley, Bill Cosby, and John Cena. I got nothing else. That's not funny. I'm annoying. I'm damn annoying right now. Okay. We got this bad boy. I got this bad boy right here. We don't need to do that. Okay, that opens here. I can put this bad boy right here. That's pretty nice. And then it looks like I can do blast this guy out like that. That lowers him, and then just put it back in. That's what I'm talking about. Assumptively. Oh, nice. I don't know if it gives you extra points.
I've started to collate information from my local instance. It seems the crew intentionally cut communication with the satellite.
Why?
It appears we had a disagreement.
Uh-oh. That ain't good. Good old disagreements. All right. Let's do this. That one's like way up there. Probably doesn't need to be that high. I would assume it doesn't need to be that high. Okay. Now this one. You know, the thing is, it doesn't need to be like that perfect. I bet it could go down even a little bit further to be able to step up it. That is my assumption. Doesn't mean it's anywhere close to correct. I think that this can go down a little bit. Maybe like right there. What do you guys think? I think it's pretty good. And now... now we try to make a little leap of faith, baby. Let's go. That's why I like first-person puzzlers. These puzzle games are so good, and honestly, I can't wait to play. There's a couple other games I want to play that I won't talk about right now, but there's one that just came out that I'm so excited about that we will definitely be doing a similar video on. Look at that. There you go, genius. Why don't you just walk across? Big giant stupid ass. Look at that. Woohoo! What was that, like 9 tries?
This confirms my fears. The crew have made intentional breaches of my security. The crew have attempted to compromise my systems.
What does this mean?
They don't want to be found. They are hiding.
From who?
Us.
Tom is watching, huh?
Tom is watching us. Tom is watching us from a distance. Ooh,
that's really annoying. I'm sorry I ruined this good game by singing that. Is that my favorite book? You bet it is. You bet it is. Okay. Freaking cupboards. Cupboards everywhere. Cupboards everywhere. Access denied. Well, this is the end of video one, guys. Thank you so much for hanging out. Please comment, subscribe, and like. Comments below me. Comments below this. Thank you guys so much. I will see you in the next video. I will see you next time. 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 Really good game. I'm impressed. I'm excited to play the rest of it. And August 30th, $20. Definitely worth $20. I would pay a lot more for it. That is the first 3 chapters. My name is Faye, and I hope you all have a good day.